Welcome to tonight's game. It promises to be a good one between the Texas Tech Red Raiders and the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Number two is one of the players we anticipate will be getting a lot of minutes tonight.
It's hard to stop this young man in offense. When he gets going, Brad, he's got the J, he's got offensive penetration, you name it, this kid's got it, baby.
The Cowboys will definitely try and capitalize on his capabilities tonight, Dick. The Cowboys know they're looking at a good one tonight, Dick. What are the keys for them to win?
I would think that the keys are as follows. First, the point guard has to be the coach on the floor, making sure his team executes on every possession. Next, be strong with the ball. Turnovers can be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball. Lastly, play your game on defense. Let your defense dictate their offense.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. From left of the circle.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best. Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
And he's going to pick up the foul. And, oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Howard handles the pass. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Gave it up. Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Looking for a good shot. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Now they work it around the perimeter for the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Trying to pack it inside. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Tries for two. And the ball goes out of bounds. Fed the low block. The center receives the ball. Now they're into it. That's got some people out of their seats.
What a response. What enthusiasm.
He intercepts it. Cross court. Trying to draw the foul. Up. Easy one. Tightly, and then he went for the steal. An unsuccessful attempt resulting in a personal foul.
You see, that's what happens when you go for the steal. You end up with unnecessary personal fouls.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. This whole team that's on the field. There's the rejection. He keeps the dribble as they reset. He shoots from downtown. Dick at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
Inside. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it. He brought the ball back down. The floor and stripped him. I don't know what I enjoyed more, Brad. The dunk of watching the mascot. What a reaction. He's really into it.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And he's going to pick up the foul. And, oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
The post flashes up high if he wants it. And there's a lazy pass, it's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? On the outside. He takes the shot off the baseline. He buries the shot. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Inside. Entry pass in the paint.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Tries a three. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
He'll regroup the offense. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Tries to get the D to bite. For two. Sinks it.
Poor job offensively. If I'm coaching, he's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He unloads a three. Great shot. Looking for a good shot. The small forward handles the feed. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Sort of dumped down inside. Nobody rotated down from up on top.
Steps to the line for the first time. He makes it.
Makes those free throws come. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
The center receives the pass. And they come with a double team to stop it.
He ran his man into the screen and dropped in a beautiful bucket.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. With a little baby hook.
Otero, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
They work it around the perimeter. Way out on top, controlling the ball. He lets it fly. Questionable shot selection there.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
He hits the shot. In the paint. That's been moves not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
They're working around the perimeter. Jumps into the defender, and he scores despite the hack. And now they'll bring it up. Gave it up. He shoots from long range. Buried it. He up fakes. There's a double team waiting there.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting.
They'll work it around the arc. On the outside.
That's spacing.
Picks off the lazy pass.
Dump it inside.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
They push it up on the break. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. For the bucket. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
He gets the rejection.
There it is, Jam City.
Controlling the ball.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
For two, he hits it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Here's a double team. Puts up the tray. Way off target. Texas Tech are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. They're going to call that a backcourt violation.
Somebody got a little nervous that time, Brad.
Dick, how's our focus player doing so far? I know it's a little bit earlier, but what are you seeing?
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. You're exactly right. And he has really excelled in every category. But everybody else is just watching.
He gets the shot to fall. It's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I'll tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
The Red Raiders have a number of seniors in their lineup. That factor alone will definitely help their cause. Entry pass in the paint. Time to pick up the defense here now. Off the rim and no good. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Double team now, bad angle.
He goes for three. He drains the bucket.
There's the trap.
He shoots. The Cowboys have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Oklahoma State is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
Number 50 with the fake. Goes up for two.
I love this guy, Hook. He cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
Looking for a good shot. Way out on top. Controlling the ball.
Let's check out this replay, Brad.
Gets it to fall. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great
job. With a rejection. He nails the shot. Moving it around the perimeter. The dribble, gives it up. There they come with a double team to stop it. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Gave it up. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. On the dribble, gives it up.
Turnover City, though, always really negate any offense.
Working it around the perimeter. On the outside. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
Gave it up. There's a double team waiting there. Pull-up jumper from way out. He gets that one to fall. Up with a shot, and it's in and out for the bucket. It's good. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from the top of the circle, goes in. Lockhart is feeling great out there right now.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
Looking for a good shot from downtown. It sticks.
This is simply a great play, Brad.
He's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Now they work it around the perimeter. In the paint. Good job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
He makes a nice shot fake. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Takes the pass in the paint. There's the fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
That was nice. The skip pass is picked off. Gave it up. Lobs it inside. Intercepted.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Here's a double team. Tears it away.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way to be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Turnaround jumper. And off the mark.
Great defensive play. Anticipating well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys are reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Foul charge. And he's going to pick up the foul. And oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
is at the charity stripe. Makes his first. Second shot is no good. For two, they still don't score.
Hey, Brad, this youngster is showing how to put the clamp on a player defensively.
Spectacular defensive effort. On the dribble, gives it up. He throws it up from downtown. He gets the bucket.
Soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. Holland hits the three. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He buries it.
That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipated really well.
Samuel's inferior play is really affecting his composure now.
He's got to snap out of it. His team needs him. That's basic.
Entry pass in the paint. He puts it in with contact and all. Two for one opportunity.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper from right at the circle. The Cowboys have found a player who cannot seem to miss it.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
On the inside. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
Look at that celebration. He is pumped. He's trying to pump up the fans, too. He's saying, hey, come along for the ride.
And he's getting what he wants. This is what I love to see. The energy, the emotion, and passion, baby. Double team now, bad angle.
The Cowboys have got to continue to get him the ball.
And he's on fire.
Boys are down by eight. We've had a very tight contest tonight, Dick. What's your highlight of the half?
Check out some of the inside play we witnessed in the first half. We saw some great baskets down low, which really opened up the outside range for both teams.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. Oklahoma State has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turn it over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Our focus player update, Dick Vitale's going into the second half. What does he need to do, you think?
I would run him off screens on the right and left. I would set up screens and have him pop out to shoot that trifecta. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
They're whistling for a backcourt violation.
Those kinds of mistakes kill momentum opportunities.
And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Out there, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their teams quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
On the outside. The crowd loves this young man.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for him.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. They work the perimeter. Up fake. And he'll kick it back outside. From the top of the key. Makes it. Goes for the deep one. Knocks it down.
Back it up, back it up. We'll see that one again.
Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
Makes the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Stolen. Defense got it after knocking it loose. Up. Easy one.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
Working it around the perimeter. Working around the perimeter. There's the pick. There's the roll. 10 on the shot clock. Fakes a jumper. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Transition opportunity coming up. Gave it up. And they get the turnover. My goodness, seems like it's a track meet up there.
You've got to be in superb condition to play this tempo, Brad. The pressure's getting to him, Brad.
From three-point land. That's good. Takes away the pass. We have a backcourt violation.
Mistakes like that can add up in games like this.
That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love that.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Perfectly executed. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. On the outside. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Oh. lets it fly. He shows the sweet touch. Around the arc for two, perfectly executed. Steals the ball. The ball goes out of bounds. Full house. Packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team. Say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling act here and turns it over.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. What a Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
Takes the pass in the paint.
He allowed the screen to develop before he tossed in a nice inside basket.
Up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
He looks for the bomb. Buried it.
Spacing.
For the bucket. Got it. Looking for a good shot. He tries the three. Makes the shot. And the fans are going wild.
Well, listen to those fans. The crowd is thunderous.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Perfectly executed. Ball was knocked loose, but the offense got it back.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. Picks off the pass. Tries for two. You betcha. Gave it up. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Attempts a three. Great shot. He tries the three ball. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action.
The dribble, gives it up.
Slam jam bam, up and away, the elevator man, they love it. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Puts it up, looking for contact. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
got some room. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Way off target. He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gonna eliminate those turnovers.
And he'll kick it back outside. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Fadeaway. He misses the fadeaway. Burgess makes a great move to draw the foul. Watch out, Dick. Their emotions seem to be getting the better of them.
I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Second shot is good. The Cowboys are a frustrated bunch right now, I think.
Hey, partner, you really are sharp. That's a great observation. If they don't turn things around in a hurry, it could snowball into something much worse.
Nice shot. Picked off. It rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
He threw down that dunk and got the foul.
You've got to foul him harder than that if you're going to foul.
Number 23 steps in for the first time tonight.
This may or may not have been the right substitution at this point, Brad.
Foul shot is not good. And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
All right, let's check in. Third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, this is not the start he wanted tonight. He is his team's marquee performer, and his slow start could be a recipe for disaster. We'll have to see how his teammates respond to all this, and we'll continue to monitor it from the sideline. Brad?
The game is changing, Brad. These days, guys are consistently playing above the rim.
Wide stance and the drop step.
I tell you, it's all about angles, and if you utilize that drop step, it's like a reverse pivot move.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Rims off. It's his second. That's why I love this game, Dick, for that reason alone.
Wow, the energy in here is electrifying. Pushing that basketball.
Picked out of the air. He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there. Pump fakes. Kicks it out. Got a guy right up on him. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch. I sometimes wonder what it would be like to be a Skywalker, elevating and throwing it down, Mr. Nestler. How much fun would that be?
They work it around the perimeter, in the paint.
There's the trap.
Moving it around the perimeter. The shooting guard takes the feed.
Oh, what a great job transition. Offense, poor job defensively. Don't get back, don't stop the ball. And they were allowed to convert, get the number game going.
Takes away the pass. For the deuce. This team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're finding each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot.
Samuel, he takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's one you take for the team, Brad.
Number 21 gets his first sweat of the night.
Hey, it's important that this kid gets into the offensive action right away, Brad. He's going to make an instant impact.
Makes the foul shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up for two for the bucket. Basket falls despite the contact. Now they work it around the perimeter. Looking for a screen on top and got it. He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
Gave it up. Tries to turn. The defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the outside. Had a guy in the post but elected to reverse the ball. Tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
The Cowboys are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless. He intercepts it, pushes it.
Stop the ball. Will somebody stop the ball?
This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
They just have to focus, Brad. That's most important, mental toughness.
Not there. They just can't seem to miss.
They've had a serious stroke with their shooting, Brad.
Momentary look from three-point land for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He attempts the trifecta. He nails the shot. It on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player. Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
The ball goes out play. But Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
I'll tell you one thing, they're dropping and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays. Coming inside.
Takes the pass in the paint. Goes up for two. Up and in. missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. He pump fakes. Runs him first, it, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Look at the student section, Dick, cheering on their classmates, their peers. If you ask any coach or player, I'm sure they'll say that the student section is the best.
Isn't it great, Brad?
Wide open for the shot. Adam in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. From the baseline, they'll bring it out on top. Too physical. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
There's a double team waiting there.
Nice high post screen.
Ain't no stopping them right now from the arc, Dick.
You better believe it, baby. They're making them pay from out there.
Got a much needed breather with that timeout. Ten on the shot clock.
Inside.
The student body appears to be pumped up and they are ready to explode.
The student section looks like they're having a great time.
The point guard gets the pass.
Look at that spacing.
They move it into the front court. The center with the ball.
Gonna take some pride on the defensive end.
Gotta be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick.
They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
And we'll go to the free throw line. Sinks it. Go back out onto the floor. He shoots from the top of the circle.
They should try for an early foul here.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Well, Mr. Vitale, let's take a look at our backcourt production.
Hey, I'll tell you one thing, Brad. You look at the stats, you want to find out if your backcourt is playing well. Well, you want to ensure that your guards keep the number of turnovers down. That's a must. Reduce turnovers. So many games are won or lost by teams turning the ball over. Turnovers, missed opportunities happen, baby, when you turn the rock over. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
No doubt. Shot good. Shot clock is dead. The lead is now 7 points.
This game is still up for grabs, Brad.
He lets it go. gets it to go. And yet another foul. There's the turnover situation for the half there.
I tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in the game at the end drops significantly.
Misses. They're not getting the balls to fall from the line.
Hey, if I were the coach of this team, I would make them run so many lines, I would pass out from watching them run, Brad.
Second shot is no good. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
He steps up to the line. He misses the first. And they're catching nothing but iron at the free throw line, Dick.
They're going to catch more than that from their coach if they don't start putting them down, Brad.
Second one is no good. Dick, this team is having some serious problems at the free throw line.
And it's a collective effort by all of them tonight.
Hollins goes to the line for the first time. Misses the first shot. Not a very good night at the line, Dick.
Absolutely no excuse for that, Brad. No excuse.
Second one is good.
They need to score here to turn this into a one-possession game.
It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
He looks for the bomb. Rims out. The shooting guard takes the pass. Dick, we look now that the game is over at our focused player, and I don't know if it was the defensive focus by the other team, but he didn't have it tonight.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. It's so essential for the star player to really respond. He didn't respond at all in a positive way, and it affected his teammates as well.
Oklahoma State comes away with a win.
They'll be happy to walk away with a victory from such an evenly matched opponent.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.